Okay, good afternoon. My name is Abdullah Kreisha, and I'm going to talk today about visible light enhanced 5G system. So before going and talking about the details and the solution, let us see the problem first, and based on that, let us... Okay, so the first problem everybody is familiar with is the spectrum crunch. Okay, so here is data from Cisco expectation that in 2019 we'll have 11 the required wireless data will grow 11 times. Going back to what the keynote speaker said, so in 2015, 70% of the video data is gonna be requested from indoor location, okay? And according to Cisco Network King Index, in 2018, even the outdoor data, 53% of that is gonna be offloaded indoor to Wi-Fi. So this is the first motivation. So we have the spectrum crunch. We cannot fit all this into the spectrum. The second problem that we have is energy-hungry wireless networks. Okay, wireless access networks. In the US in 2011, the IT energy consumption was more than the whole automotive industry. Okay, wireless mobile infrastructure consumes half of this amount, which is a very big amount. And with the exponential growth of the data rate and the data and the demand, this amount will increase. Okay. Now the third one, which kind of overlooked, the third motivation for this work, is, sorry to say that, okay, but there is a clear evidence, especially in 2014, 2015, and I will show you data, that there is an indication and evidence that cellular phones will cause cancer, okay? Let us see. WHO, the World Health Organization, classifies the cell phones as a possible carcinogen, which is brain cancer, okay? WHO also put the cell phones in the same risk factor as the this is in February 2015. They put the cell phones in the same risk factor as the chloroform from gasoline and the DDT. And there is a study in 2010 that shows that people who are using the cell phones for more than 10 years, they have doubled the chance of brain tumor cancer called glioma. Okay? This is the director of the WHO, World Health Organization Cancer Research. This is what he said. This is in 2015. He said, given the potential consequences for public health, it is important to take action for that. Okay? And the cell phone company started to look into this problem. Okay, and there is a website, www.phonecausesbraincancer.com. If you go there, you will see many scary things that will warn us from what's going on. Here is just an example. Again, I'm not a medical doctor or anything, but here is an example. If you look at the left-hand side, okay, you will see the brain after 10 minutes. After 20-minute phone call, and you see the hyperactivity, the red color there on the left-hand side means hyperactivity, and this could cause cancer. Okay. So based on these three challenges, as I said, the spectrum crunch, which is the capacity challenge, the energy problem, consumption, and the health issue, we want to build a unified, hopefully, next, as the keynote speaker says, there is no way to expect what's 5G. And given that most of the traffic, in my slide, 70%, but the keynote speaker, he said, it's even more, it's 80% of the traffic is indoor. So I want to build a good indoor next generation 5G system or indoor wireless access network. And here is the unified solution that I'm proposing. So the solution here is a hybrid system that will coexist both the RF, which could be Wi-Fi because I'm talking about indoor, and the visible light communication. Visible light communication here means communicating the signals through the light, okay? One big motivation here, there is a new service by Cisco called Smart Light as a Service or Connected Lighting. The service is the following. They are producing new smart LED or light sources. These LED or light sources can be connected through Ethernet switches. The reason right now is to control them through the internet. So you can control the lighting, minimize the energy, everything. We can easily, I will show you, we have a real implementation and we have a test bed at NGIT. We can easily add to this light as a service that's provided by Cisco, and there is another company called TCP Lighting. We can add a small interface that will add the modulation between the control and the light, and then we can utilize visible light communication for communication. So the motivation here from the capacity perspective, because the range is very small, I'm talking about, so the spatial reuse will be very high, so can increase the capacity very high. From the energy perspective, which I will focus on this talk about, I can jointly do lighting and communication. So especially at night, I need specific level of illumination. And for indoor application, you know, the Wi-Fi router, most of the energy is idle sensing. So it's not the energy you communicate. It's just turning on the router. The Wi-Fi router consumes 90% of the maximum. So what I can do, I can leverage this system depending on the lighting condition. In the morning, I can use the RF. And at night, I can jointly do lighting or depending on the winter or summer. And obviously, this one it does not affect the health, so it will solve the three problems. So let us see the solution that we developed in my lab to develop this test bed and this future hybrid system. So the first thing is the VLC front end, the VLC devices, because the Wi-Fi devices, the Wi-Fi and the RF devices are existing everywhere. So let us do the RF front VLC front end. Okay, so it developed with cooperation with Boston University and Fraunhofer HHI. This is a research lab in Germany. It uses three colors, red, green, blue. There are lenses at the receiver that will filter which color with which wavelength, and like the concept of WDMA on the fiber optics. And it uses the OFDM. There are other kind of modulation, but for high data rate, we use OFDM. And this is from the circuit design people in the group that I'm working with. They do a careful impedance matching, and they were achieve 100 megahertz. And this is the devices. Okay, let me show you now a video from my lab of these devices, just quick. Video, okay? I don't know the voice. Sorry for the...
Response. And now I move the paper away.
Okay, so yeah, so I think this will be, so as you can see, this communicates through the light. There are many issues here. For example, here is a performance of our old device. It can achieve 70 megabit per second, but we are working on a device almost done. It can achieve 500 megabit per second. So as you can see, everywhere I need to do communication indoor, I need lighting. So I can hand over between them. There is a lot of work we did on handover and other things. So as you can see, here is the performance of the device. Here is a hybrid system that will coexist both of them, simple hybrid system. As you can see, the throughput for each user can be doubled, okay, because I can do channel aggregation and connect to two users at the same time. Okay. And here is the delay. Even when I'm doing channel aggregation, the delay is reduced. Okay. So now I'm going to focus on the other problem, which is the power control problem. Joint lighting and power control. Before I talk about the system model, as I said, the motivation for this work is that at night I need lighting, so I'm getting it free, lighting and communication. And in the morning, I can switch to the other one. Okay, so we have a hybrid system containing of KRF and VLC hotspots. Okay, this distributed. Okay, so for the RF hotspot, what I need to know is, because you see this is short range communication and we are working on the high SNR region, so the power will be almost linear with, and we tested that in our lab, that the power will be linear with the data rate. Okay, so all what I need to know, what's the and from many studies and conferred from our lab, about 80% is just to turn on the device. While even the device is idle doing nothing, I'm consuming about 80%. So this is for the RF hotspot. For the VLC, what we are doing here, we are running optimization problem in the beginning to find what is the illumination level required. And based on that, we, because in LEDs, there is two kind of energy consumption. There is the optical power on the signal, but this does not mean the total consumed power. The total consumed power is the electrical one, and they use efficiency. For people who work on LED, they use the efficiency, which what we noticed in our lab, even with the same send optical power, if you change the data rate, the efficiency of the LED device will change. So based on that, okay, we characterize it here for our devices that we have in our lab, that the efficiency is decreasing with the data rate according to this one. So the efficiency is the optical, is the electrical power, which is the total consumed power, divided by the optical power. Therefore, the way we do here power control, we are sending at the same optical power, but again, there is two components, DC and AC. DC is just for lighting. AC is both lighting and communication. If I want to increase the data rate, I decrease the DC power level and increase the AC and up to a specific point. So with this one, the VLC device can be characterized the same thing, P on and the power to serve the user. Therefore, we can formulate the problem as a mixed integer linear problem. So this problem means I want to minimize the total power. The first term is turning on the device. And as you can see, for Wi-Fi, turning on and off is the same in the morning and at night. But for VLC, it's changing. At night, I'm getting it free. Go ahead. Okay. At night, I'm getting it free because I'm doing lighting. But in the morning, I am paying that one. Okay. Subject to that, you cannot connect the device. Y means you connect to the device. X is you turn on the device. You cannot connect the device unless it is turned on. And each user has to be served. That's the last constraint. Okay? So we proved that this problem is NP-complete. We reduced it from the well-known problem in computer science called set cover. Now, the challenge here is that I can have many approximations, but all of these will be done offline. I want something online, which means every time a user comes, I decide and I cannot reverse my decision. Okay, so due to that, we developed an online algorithm, okay, using the primal dual approach. The details, I don't want to go to the details. And this algorithm, okay, we can achieve a competitive ratio. Competitive ratio means the performance of the online divided by the performance of the best offline algorithm, okay? Or, sorry, the opposite. So this one achieves O log M log N competitive ratio, where N is the number of hotspots and M is the number of hotspots and is the number of users. And we also prove that there is no online algorithm that can achieve better than omega log of M. So this algorithm is efficient. Let us see now some kind of simulation results, okay? We have two settings. We have one setting, one big room without windows, okay? So we need lighting, okay? As you can see here we have a fixed power. We don't want to exceed that power, and we want to see how many users can be supported given that power. So as you can see, I can increase the number of users depending on the, sometimes it can go, I can double the number of users with the same amount of power. The other one is the simulation when we have windows, okay? Room with windows, okay? So as you can see, we simulated in January, in April, in July, and in October. As you can see in January, for example, the ambient light is not very much, okay? So as you can see, at night, the VLC is always good in all of them, because at night I need to do joint illumination and communication. But in the morning, as you can see, in the summer, the VLC beats the Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi beats the VLC. But in winter, for example, it's always that the VLC is better than the Wi-Fi. But as you can see, the red one is the hybrid system. It's always better than both of them because it utilizes both of them. And as you can see, I can cut, depending on the situation, I can cut the energy into 60%. Remember here, there is 100 million Wi-Fi device in the world right now. And this is expected to go to 500 million. So if each one of them, I can cut 60%, that will be a huge amount of energy saving. And here are other results for the number of users that can be supported. Finally, I just want to acknowledge our partner. So NGIT, we are working on the networking part of the project. Boston University, they are working on the communication part of the project. And Fraunhofer, they are from Germany, they are working on the device level of the project. Thank you very much.